The Marcos administration secures the commitment of the Intergovernmental Finance Institution OPEC Fund to address right-of-way acquisition issues in its big-ticket infrastructure projects. Such issues are said to hinder the construction of key infra projects, including the Metro Manila subway. The finance department announced Tuesday that OPEC Fund made that commitment on the sidelines of the World Bank International Monetary Fund spring meetings in Washington, D.C. in April. There, OPEC Fund also expressed interest in funding the Public Financial Management Reform Program, which aims to ensure the effective delivery of public services, especially for the poor. The Philippines makes its return to the international bond market. It announced on Tuesday the issuance of dual tranche U.S. dollar bond offering, the first under the Marcos administration this year, which has a tenor of 10 years and a 25-year sustainability tranche. The initial price guidance for the 10-year tenor is set around the level of Treasuries plus 120 basis points. Now, the 25-year sustainability bond, meanwhile, is set around 6.05%. The proceeds of the bond issuance will be used for general budget financing. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto told Bloomberg, government is seeking to raise as much as $2 billion from the bond sale. He added the offer is part of a plan to raise about $5 billion in funding from overseas markets for the year. The World Bank extends its support to local governments in the Philippines. The International Financial Institution met with members of the Union of Local Authorities of the Philippines on Monday to help address challenges faced by local governments, including infrastructure and environment. ULAP emphasized the need for capital investments, technical expertise, and direct partnerships with the World Bank to address resource constraints and enhance service delivery. Now, the group asserts there is a need for government to empower its local arms, which it said is key to the country's economic growth. The country's unemployment rate climbs to 3.9% in March from the 3.5% in February. The Statistics Bureau says this is equal to 2 million jobless Filipinos. The underemployment rate, meanwhile, was down to 11% from the previous 12.4%. The number of those with jobs but are looking for more hours of work stood at 5.4 million. Filipinos are urged by an advertising group to be discerning of political ads a year before the midterm elections. Lady Vicencio reports.
As the election season nears, political advertising is again expected to occupy various media. In an event of the Ad Standards Council, kapisanan ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas Chairman Ruperto Nicdao Jr. reminded the public to be critical of poll ads, especially on digital media. KBP is one of the organizations that established the ASC and continues to be a member of the regulatory body.
Ang ginagawa na lang natin for us an industry is to remind people, especially during elections, to be more discerning about the messages that's put out there. I know, especially digital media, less on traditional media because meron tayong mga sa mga desk natin, there are editors that make sure na hindi tayo makuryente.
The self-regulatory body of the advertising industry reiterated its mandate to uphold truth in advertising and promote consumer protection. Nicdao mentioned that at least 50% of advertisements are now placed on digital media.
Media and advertising communications impacts on social behavior. Whatever we show them, in fact, what I've been mentioning always is that advertising kasi paulit-ulit yan, di ba? So pag inulit-ulit mo yung sinasabi mo, people will believe that. Okay, so if you come up with misinformation through advertising or through any form of media, people will believe that. Sabi nga ni Goebbels, yung information minister ni Hitler, you know, a lie repeated often enough becomes truth. So if you, and advertising is repetition, no? You keep repeating your message. So napakahalaga na ensure that whatever we put out there, whether it's advertising or content, what you do, in fact, you're in media, has to be truthful. especially in this age where we have a lot of disinformation on not, well, there's some in traditional media, but more disinformation happens, I know, in digital media.
Former Senator Francisco Kitatad, who was also co-chairman of the Mass Media Advisory Council, advised public officials to present ideas and platforms in their ads.
What we need to do, if you are in public office, is to be able to give our countrymen a vision of what we can become, no? A vision of what to aspire for. Oh, hindi tayo nagbabangayan personalities, one against another, here and there.
The former lawmaker was among the 22 honorees of the ASC for pioneering self-regulation in the advertising industry. Tatad adds he is in favor of allowing foreign ownership of advertising companies in the country.
It has proven to the world that the Filipinos can do a very good job at it and that they can stand competition from the foreigners. That's why we are ready to face foreign competition. And that's why there is a move now in Congress to open up ownership of media and advertising to foreign competition. I have always been in favor of that because nakikita ko yung puhunang dayuhan at yung talinong dayuhan dapat pumasok sa Pilipinas para makatulong sa atin. Hindi ko nakikita yung the threat of being stifled by the foreigners. Yung Pilipino mas magaling naman kasi mga ibang lahi.
ASC marked its 50 years of self-regulating the advertising industry, which it believes to be more efficient in resolving complaints and cheaper compared to being regulated by the government.
If you don't self-regulate, that means government will have to regulate. Based on the experiences of all companies involved in the industry, that is not only expensive, but it's very slow. It's inefficient, and not because government is intrinsically efficient, but they're concerned with a lot of other things rather than regulating advertising content.
In bringing its pioneers together, the council looks to renew its commitment in upholding responsible advertising. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.